identified with, so I wouldn't sound exactly like somebody else. That's not that easy to do. It takes a lifetime to do it sometimes. Anyway, that's what I've been trying to do. Devout Christian, my mother was as well. My father never approved of playing jazz in the church, and he never approved of playing jazz on Sundays. Of course, but in my line of work, you cannot dictate the time of day or the day of the week that you have to play. So. My father would not have been very happy. In fact, I recall once when I was about 13 years old, shortly after I first started to play, I was working on a little dance engagement in Pontiac. And my father showed up at 11:30 on Saturday night. And at 12:05, I had to leave the bandstand because I would have played over. He didn't approve of my playing jazz on Sunday, so I had to leave the bandstand. That's a very true thing. It happened more than once, by the way. Even to this day, everything is a learning experience for me. I remember, though, the first time my teacher tried to explain to me the stride piano, I remember the tune that she used to, as an illustration, was called Between the Devil and the Deep Blue Sea. I'll never forget that. Maybe I play a little bit of it, and then here's what she told me. I'll play the key of F. That was the first tune that I tried to play stride on. It was kind of a difficult tune too, really, you know, because the release is different. But anyway, that was the very first thing I tried to play stride on. That was the only style that I thought was relevant at the time. I've learned since that that's not the only way to play the piano, but it was a good way to start. Well, when I first began to play the piano, I think I started to imitate the sounds that I heard, you know. I just heard a pianist named Fats Waller. You might have heard of him. Fats was a great stride piano player. And in the tradition of James P. Johnson, but I had not heard of James P. Johnson at that time. But Fats Waller was a great, great stride pianist. And along about the time that I was going to junior high school, you know, in the morning, there was a radio station in Detroit, Michigan that played 45 minutes of Fats Waller's recordings. So every morning, every school day, before I went to school, I could hear at least a half hour of Fats Waller stride piano. And that was a good way to start the day. Mm-hmm. when I first met a Thelonious Monk, he was working at a club on 52nd Street. I think it was the Three Deuces, but I met him a little bit prior to that, and we started talking. He invited me to visit him in his apartment, which was not that far away. I think he lived on the Lower West Side in Manhattan, somewhere near Lincoln Center, the way that Lincoln Center is located now, but maybe a little south of there. Anyway, I accompanied him to his apartment, and he sat down and played. He started playing Monk's Mood. I didn't know that was the title of it at the time, but he said, I'm going to play this, and he said, I want you to write it down as I play it. So I played it, and I tried to write it down as he played. So that arrangement that I played, the version of it that I played, is the one that he played. So it's pretty authentic. It may not be the same as the one you might see in some of the fake books, you know, but this is the way Monk played it, and that's the way I wrote it down. But that was my introduction to Monk's music, really. And quite an introduction, I might say, because it wasn't easy. Because a lot of the harmonies that he was playing were not, all of them were not completely alien to me. They were certainly unusual, and perhaps not the harmonies that I would have used had I constructed the harmony according to his melody. But that was my introduction to Monk. It's representative of Monk's style of playing, which was different harmonically than almost anybody else you can name. And it's very difficult to imitate his style because most pianists don't think in terms of his harmonic conception. The chords that he plays are quite different. They're substitution chords. Other pianists would use different chords in that same location that Monk used his chords in. But that's typical Monk.